Hi, and welcome to the Happy Tree Friends sound effects commentary. This is Jim Lively.
Jim Lively.
Principal sound designer for Mondo Media.
And Ken Navarro.
Sleeping on the
job.
Yes, we're here late at night.
And Rody Montijo, welcome.
We will be your tour guides to the wonderful world of sound that is Happy Tree Friends.
I'd like to start out this commentary by thanking a couple of people. Asha Ken, who is the primary composer under the name of RJ11, wrote all the music, that wonderful theme that you hear again and again and again. You can't get it out of your mind, and you wish you could. Jonathan Bach, who worked here for a while and was a sound effects editor. Cadet Kuhn, who is one of the great sound designer and sound effects editors that I've ever worked with. She worked on some of these episodes. And Sarah Costablanco, who did a lot of the recording of the voiceover, which are pretty much vocal gestures. So I'm going to go through some of the sound effects that are part of Eye Candy, because there's some fun ones in there. Really gross stuff.
Good times all around.
To start with, if you listen to the episodes, you rarely hear anybody running. But in this case, looking at the picture, we all thought that, yeah, we ought to hear some footsteps in this. So I added some running.
Those are real beaver footsteps, though, right?
Yeah. Yes, we had 18 beavers audition for that Foley assignment. And
we put them on a treadmill, right?
Right. So the first thing that you come across is the tripping over the log. There's a wood impact in there. Of course, it's a vocal gesture, and then...
Vocaled by Warren Graff.
Warren Graff, brilliant performance. And then there's the body fall. That's a library sound. That's just a body falling on dirt. However, there are a few things added to it. There are a couple of hits, punches, kind of sloppy punches, and there's also a watermelon or cassava melon, I can't remember which, being crunched.
And me hitting Rody a lot.
Yeah, yeah.
He loves that.
I record it and, you know, edit, and boy.
We're good to go.
Yeah. So when we've got the lollipop hanging out underneath the eye, and as Toothy's pulling out the lollipop, there's a tension squeak, which is a violin bow being tensioned and squeaked.
Wow.
And then the eye pop, which is a very special sound that Asha Ken made quite a while ago. We call it baby grab for no particular reason.
It's the randomness that is Happy Tree Friends, folks.
But it's a really wet, sloppy impact.
I think one of the cool things with working with Jim is sometimes we'll be like, Jim, we need a sound of a tooth falling out, landing in a kind of a squishy noise.
And he'll take a moment and go, I got it. And then on the keyboard, buried in some sub-level in the file folder somewhere, called some obscure name,
like baby grab.
And it's perfect. It's like, that's it. That's the sound.
And if we don't have it in library or things we've already created, we have to make it.
That's so, where the magic begins.
Yes. So as the eye pops out and goes flying off, there's another library sound, which is an incoming mortar round without the explosion. That was edited off. And then as it wraps around the tree, that's actually just three electrical cords that I recorded swinging around real fast.
Good times.
Watch out for your eyes.
And there's some cartoon standard, the balloon sounds as he's grabbing onto the nerve. The bird, when it starts to peck, that's just like regular woodblock pecks. But there's some subtle sounds. There's eight layers of subtle sounds underneath that, which sound really gross. And it's a chicken carcass being sort of ripped apart. Just we had fun that day.
Don't ask us why. It's just there.
So then the next thing that happens is poor Toothy stops abruptly at the end of. Oh, I should mention before that, there's an echo on his voice. If you're listening in full surround, 5.1 surround...
Stereo.
No, not stereo. Full 5.1 surround.
Excuse me.
You'll hear that that echo is behind you. If you don't have 5.1 surround set up...
Just imagine it.
Just think of things behind you.
Stereo.
If you don't have it, then you should go get it.
Absolutely. So then there's the stop, which is another crushed melon. couple of other things that were smushed pretty badly and interestingly, and some squishes. Then we come to when Toothy's climbing up the nerve, which is a sound that Ken and I worked together to make.
Painfully.
The first idea was to do fingernails on chalkboards, which I have in the library, but we wanted something a little bit different, and we searched and searched. We tried a bunch of different things. Finally, we came across a piece of styrofoam rubbed against a roll of cling wrap. But it's such a wonderful sound.
It is. It was the perfect sound, but dang, oh my gosh, every time I had to rake it over, my teeth had to clench down. Oh, it was bad. Good times.
So then, of course, Toothy stops again, which is pretty much the same sounds, different variations, different recorded tracks. Then his brain pulls out. That's more gloopy. I think we used Baby Grab, another Baby Grab in there again.
Baby Grab 2.0?
Might have reversed it for the brain coming through. And then the final little tiny body fall after his brain and ire popped out. And, of course, is the visual iris is down. There's another incoming mortar and the bird poop, which is yet another sloppy, glucky baby.
But that was classy. Classy.
Classy. It was classy. It's classy poop, so it had to be a very classy sound.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Yes, indeed, Jim, indeed.
So that's it. Enjoy Happy Tree Friends and...
enjoy the sound of Happy Tree Friends.
I hope you learned a little bit more with the behind the scenes of the sound effects with Jim Lively.
Because that's what we're all about here. Learning, growing, sharing.